Hi, it's Susanna Troy. First, of course, it is unacceptable and it is horrific to attempt to shoot or assassinate an NYPD officer. And I'm saying that as a victim of NYPD, who wasn't a few bad apples, party to the goal to erase all crimes for Dr. Andrew Fagelman, who for me is like a Jeffrey Epstein Jr. or wannabe. I'm not telling you he is a pedophile, but when I met Epstein, and my experience with Epstein was he was not a pedophile. At that time, he was someone who was confident he was above the law and could get away with anything. And I contacted the NYPD and DA. So fast forward. Anyway, my dream, because I'm running and walking now, is to have, long after I'm gone, all day. It could be multiple marathons, or for someone handicapped in a wheelchair or handicapped like me, where I have severe degenerative disc disease. I have pains in my head from chronic insomnia. I have a ton of fibroid tumors, which my attacker, Delita Hooks, also known as Delight and D, knew about. I never told her my name, but the very first time I met her, I told her about my condition, and I told Detective Vergona as well. He knew. Detective John Vergona, who violently threatened me over the phone, and there's an admission of that in a federal appellate filing, that he threatened me with arrest unless I dropped charges. They tried to defend it by saying he said he'd arrest Delita Hooks as well, but you will note that he didn't in any way alert Delita Hooks to turn herself in, just me, the victim. And you will note I never committed a crime. I was a human punching bag. This woman violated me. She violated my patient rights from behind the desk. And then she and her enablers continued online on behalf of Dr. Angie Fagelman and Delita Hooks. She admitted Dr. Fagelman said to tell her every time Detective Andrew Dwyer contacted her, and he admitted without investigating he discussed me, Dr. Vine's patient, with his patients. There's more, but anyway, so I had this epiphany to run walk from the NYPD around City Hall to the New York FBI headquarters all day. That would be a future event, at least once a year, that maybe one day could attract worldwide people to participate. But if your family member was killed by the NYPD, or you're a victim like me, and I don't see me living X amount of more years, I would love to live a nice, peaceful life, but I can't be assured of that. I mean, people who are critics of very wealthy people and NYPD seem to live shorter lives. I've aged 100 years. I'm not going to kill myself. I don't want to die. I want to live. But why not have a run walk? And if I do this and start by myself, of course, I'm going to have to go to the bathroom a lot. There are public bathrooms, but I'm going to write City Hall, the mayor, and Corey Johnson, the speaker, and ask them if I can please have permission as part of my peaceful protest to use the toilet at City Hall. Even under Bloomberg, they let me use the toilet. And if I'm doing a public protest to bring peace, justice, and accountability, and to stop civil rights discriminations and crimes, violations, obstruction of justice, due process, to have accountability. And I believe that would help relations with the NYPD make their job safer, because there are good cops and their work is undone. Their work is undone by cops that want to act like the Blue Mafia. So my dream is long after I'm gone, there's a peace run for healing the community, but also asking that the NYPD respect the law, respect the oath they took, uphold the Constitution, stop breaking laws. And Internal Affairs and the DA and Corporate Counsel have protected them in my case. We're on 7.5 years. This is the 8th year. October 1st, 2012 will be 8 years. And it could go on for decades. So this is my idea, and I don't believe I'll be alive to see the benefits of it. But I would like a peace run at least once a year, all day. For ultra marathoners, they could run as many miles as they can. For someone severely handicapped, it may mean just doing the loop once. For someone like me, it could mean stopping and going to the bathroom and resting and getting water and then starting up again. But there has to be peaceful ways to address this and continue to bring attention to obstruction of justice. At some point, I'm getting close to a decade. If this is 8 years, this is a decade, and how can this peacefully brought to attention besides citizen databases, city, state, and federal, how we are more than failed, that sometimes, like in the Epstein case, Jeffrey Epstein and Ghislaine Maxwell had very powerful enablers. Jeffrey Epstein had enablers inside the NYPD and the Manhattan DA who've never been forced to ask questions under oath and should be televised like Prince Andrew, but these people should be questioned under oath. Randy wasn't questioned under oath, but it was enough to force him out. Yet the cops that took an oath to uphold the law, that had guns and badges in my case and in the Jeffrey Epstein case telling him to ignore a judge, they have not been held accountable. And I'm questioning if that's because it went right to the top. For me, four administrations and so many police commissioners were on Shea now, from Ray Kelly, Bratton, O'Neill to Shea.